one of the big objectives that we've got in the pre-calculus class is to be able to solve equations that involve trig factors. So here's a nice example. We want to find all the x's that would make this equation true. It's nice to observe here that we could factor out a sine of x. So this will be 2 cosines of x minus the square root of 3 that's left on the inside. Okay. A factor of sine of x here, a factor of sine of x here. So I just factored that out. And the stuff that's left here is 2 cosines of x. And the stuff that's left here is the square root of 3. At this point, then, I know that I'm worried about sine of x being equal to 0. And I'm worrying about 2 cosine of x minus the square root of 3 being equal to 0. So I just worry about those consequences. Do you know any angles that make the sine of x equal to 0?
Yeah, 0 and 180.
Yep,
there's really two answers here.
That if x is equal to 0, or if x is equal to 180 degrees, I'm going to write it in radians still.
Pi radians.
So there's two answers that I got because of this result. So now let's worry about this result. I need to, if I added the square root of 3 to both sides, divide both sides by 2, the cosine of x is equal to the square root of 3 over 2. So I'm looking for an angle. So the cosine is the square root of 3 over 2. So let me just think about where that angle could be. It's a positive amount, so it could be in this quadrant, in the first quadrant. And it could be the kind of thing, so this side right here is the square root of 3 over 2, and this side is 1.
That would be an example angle. Whatever angle that is.
It could also be any place else that the cosine is positive, and that would be right around here. It comes down here, so this is the square root of 3, and this is 1, and this is the negative amount.
So the cosine is.
So there's going to be two answers. Whatever this angle is, and whatever this angle is. Is this one of the angles that I know? Do we have an angle that has that kind of a square root of 3 over 2 and a 1 here and something over here?
Mm-hmm.
That this can probably end up being half.
So
this angle is a pi divided by 6. Okay? So x is equal to pi divided by 6. Or notice that it would also work if x was a negative pi divided by 6. Now, in this case, it could have been 0 plus 2 pi, right?
If you went 2 pi, then you'd be back at exactly the same angle. Or 4 pi. Or 6 pi. Or, right?
So all the answers are 2k times pi, where k is any integer. There's an infinite number of answers that give me this. They essentially give me the angle of 0. 0 plus 2 pi, or minus 2 pi, as many times as you want to. It'll be pi over 6 plus 2 times k times pi. They're asking for every single answer, every single possible answer, and that's right. Because pi is an answer, but pi plus 2 pi.